and in the locker room. Each guy has been going over and through his own routine to get ready. But once they take the floor, they're one single unit. Downtown Milwaukee is seen from the shore of Lake Michigan on a cloudless day. Welcome to the weekend, everybody. Let's get it going with NBA action on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan here with Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and our sideline reporter, the Hall of Famer David Aldridge. Tonight with us as well, the Book of Basketball author, Bill Simmons. Bill, great to see you.
It's great to be here. Nobody is more impressed than my 11-year-old son, who can't believe that he's playing a video game and gets to hear my voice when he hears my voice just yelling at him normally. Now he gets to hear me break down basketball.
But it's kind of fun, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, he likes that. Yeah.
Hey, Dave.
Well, almost all of the Greek Freak's points come in the paint. Giannis said, I can already do a lot of damage, basically, without a jump shot. Just driving, making plays, and free throws. When that jump shot comes, it's going to be a problem for a lot of players in this league. Kevin?
You're right, DA. It'll be scary. Thanks. Bill, in the age of positionless players and positionless basketball, is there any player that, your opinion, is more versatile than Giannis Antetokounmpo?
I think KD is probably more versatile because he can basically do anything you want offensively and guard four of the five positions defensively. I think what makes Giannis so unique is he's basically a center, but doesn't have to play center and can play any of the five positions. But if you look at his stats last year versus any Shaq season, it's basically the same season. Mm-hmm. He's doing 27 and 13. He's protecting the rim. You don't think of him as a center, but he really is. But I think what makes him special and what is the next level for him is his ability to play point forward or point center on one end, but then protect the rim on the other end. And once he adds that last piece offensively, which, you know, for Kawhi, it wasn't until, like, what, 2017? And he had that, all of a sudden he could create that little 18-footer for himself, and then he became unstoppable. That's the last piece for Giannis.
So the opening lineup for the Heat, they've got Robinson. Jones is out there with Jimmy Butler. Then it's Bam Adebayo, and it's Nunn in at the point. And for Milwaukee, Matthews and Middleton, the two wings. Giannis is the four with Lopez the five. And it's Bledsoe in at the point. And so the Milwaukee Bucks get the first points of the ballgame. Here's Butler. That shot missing. Some solid defense from Antetokounmpo. Here's Bledsoe. Some solid defense from Robinson.
Those are chances almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D, just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Miami shooting their first foul shots of the night here.
Shooting two.
He's off on the first. You've seen a handful of players land the Supermax contract, Bill. By and large, how do you see those deals working out?
It's tough. Nobody's really been happy with it yet. You know, it's so much money and it's such a big part of somebody's salary cap. And you're just kind of handicapped with it. And we've seen John Wall is the worst case scenario of it. But the situation Charlotte was in with Kemba Walker, where he makes the All-NBA team and now his Supermax is $240 million instead of $180. Like, that's crazy. And in a salary cap league, to pay $50 million a year for somebody is just nuts. It compromises the ceiling of the team. So the Bucks are going to be in this position with Giannis where he's making $55 million a year and the cap's $120 million. How are you going to put a good team around
him? You can't maneuver.
You can't. No. So I would put a wrinkle in there that I would make the Supermax, whatever, pay the player whatever the number is, but it only counts for like $32 million or something. Make it so that it's not prohibitive.
A percentage of the total cap.
Yeah, yeah, make his cap figure is 32, even if you're paying him 55, and then that way people could compete better.
And there's Bledsoe on the assist by Middleton. Bledsoe's got his second bucket.
How about the court vision of Middleton? Just so good at finding the open man.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions right now. They need a basket.
Here's Butler. That one a little long.
They are 0 for the game thus far. 0 of 4 here, still looking for their first make.
Good ball, Bam.
Heat have gone 0 of 4, missing their first 4 field goals here. Here's Nunn. His last outing, he had 18 points. Corner shot. Lopez grabs the board.
Yeah, trying to get going here, but that's an offer for the first 5 here to start the game.
The Bucks have gone 2-6 from the field. And from everything we're hearing, Bill, the draft's one and done aspect may be coming to an end. Like it?
For me, the G League is the key to all of this. I would like to see the guys come right out of high school and go into the G League and have an actual infrastructure that's attached to the real team.
And the G League is having an effect on the NBA. There are a lot of former guys from that league playing in the big league.
And the other thing is, like, sports rights are becoming more and more valuable with the streaming services and just the fact that you can watch a game anywhere you are. You can watch it on your phone. You can watch it if you're in China. You can watch it if you're in Hawaii. And I think the G League should be a bigger thing. So if they can figure out a way to kind of steal college basketball's corner with some of this stuff while also preparing these guys. The one and done, that makes no sense to me. I don't understand what anyone gains from going to college for 5 months and then pretend they're a college student.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And it's tied up with that one.
Clearly, Jimmy Butler is in the prime years of his career. And, you know, you get the feeling that no matter how much he achieves, he's always going to be looking to get better.
And that one falls, and that puts him up by 1 point. And so it's Milwaukee with it. Bledsoe passes to Antetokounmpo. Now here's Middleton, guarded by Robinson. And that's good. Chris Middleton for 3.
The obvious work ethic of Middleton on full display there. I mean, the quick release off the pass, which leaves the defense without much to do.
Here's Nunn. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. That one doesn't drop.
You know, I think the effort on defense there has everything to do with why he missed that shot. Well done.
Matthews against Robinson, and Matthews gets it to go. In 2019, Chris Middleton named an All-Star for the first time. Bill, can he be the second best player on a championship team? He was asked, I guess, to be that last year, and it didn't work.
I think he could be the third best player in a championship
team. Third, yes.
But I think you saw in the playoffs last year when they really needed the second kind of creator. I don't even want to say scorer, but somebody who could create a shot when your best guy is either sitting or having a bad game. He's just not quite there. He's too streaky, I think.
Terrific player.
Really good player. If he could definitely be one of the best 4 guys on a championship team.
Absolutely.
But as the number 2 guy, no.
Good, and the assist goes to Middleton.
And Matthews, unafraid to let it fly from the mid-range now. A consistent score from this area of the floor.
There's the pass to Butler. Oh, and there's the alley-oop. And it's slammed in by Jones.
And he pulls off the Houdini to make that catch and slam it through.
Stupendous alley-oop.
And the crowd got their jaws dropped on that one. Total disbelief.
Now, here's Matthews. 9 points last game. Giannis kicks to Bledsoe. 6 on the shot clock. Shoots from the baseline. That shot misses. And the Heat going the other way now. Last time they met was in Miami.
And the last time these two met, they were able to get a big win because of that bench production. Second unit might be a factor in this one as well.
And you know what? If they run away with this game like they did in that one, I'd expect to see plenty of minutes again for the guys coming off the bench.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
He misses the free throw. Bill, it's no secret that your heart lies in Boston. Just what was it like growing up in and around that area?
Well, it's definitely the reason I like sports as much as I do, because it's so sports obsessed. A lot of it is cold weather stuff, I feel like, where there's 5 months a year that just stink, and then there's three other months that, you know, it's just smoking hot and humid. And so the sports makes everybody kind of crazy, because you're crazy anyway. But there's nothing like being in Boston when something good's happening, like Celtics making an NBA playoff run, or the Bruins making a cup run, or the Red Sox in September when the Yankees are coming to town, or the Saturday before a Patriots game. You can kind of feel it as the community of it. That's the difference between here and a place like L.A.
It's formed you as a professional, right?
Absolutely. I mean,
yeah. The Heat shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the free throw is good, now leading by one. A different look for Milwaukee. Robin Lopez has checked in for Giannis Antetokounmpo. Pat Connaughton comes in for Chris Middleton. And it's Hill in for Eric Bledsoe. And then for Miami, Jay Crowder's checked in for Jones. And it's Iguodala in for Butler. Good on both. Here's DiVincenzo. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 9.5 points a game. Pass to Hill. Six to shoot. And Lopez has it in the corner. And the rejection by Iguodala. Pulls up, high post. Hero, no good.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. They came focused and ready to play. I mean, they're doing everything they can to put things in their favor. You earn that, and they're actually earning it well right now.
And, Bill, when it comes to NBA awards, some people have said voter fatigue is a factor. Would you agree with that?
No, I actually think NBA awards are in the best shape they've been in, because people are afraid to screw up. You know, that with the internet and the accountability we have now.
Accountability, and, exactly. And there's nothing anonymous about it. I mean, I'm...
No. Yeah. And we have really good numbers and metrics now. And I actually think we make the right decisions with this stuff most of the time now. I didn't really see any egregious stuff last year other than the one person who voted Dwayne Wade for second team All-NBA.
You get a vote, don't you?
I do, and I take it really seriously.
I do, too.
Yeah.
I feel the same way.
And I really care
about
it.
Our name is attached to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I also, like, when I wrote my book, I really relied on the All-NBA stuff. Like, they're a snapshot of what happened that season.
Good point. Now, here's Dragic. 11 points for him in that last game against Charlotte. No good on that one. Good D by Lopez. Milwaukee's gone, just 1 of 4 from three-point range here in the first. And again, the Bucks miss. Heat shooting 33% here in the first quarter. Iguodala left side. Gets a very good look and converts. So it's the Bucks now, trailing by two. Hill looking it over, shoots over Dragic, and the basket by Hill.
Pretty flashy display by Hill, really doing whatever he wants with the ball in his hand.
Pass to Crowder. Iguodala with it. Outside Dragic. Lets it go from deep. That falls. Nice feed that time from Andre Iguodala. And the Heat lead by three. Hill against Dragic. Passes to Lopez. Here's Connaughton. He's now 1 for 2 with that bucket. Bill, do you ever think we're going to eliminate conferences in the NBA playoff seeding?
I think that they would have done a 16 seed, no conference playoff format years ago. I think they're really worried about the travel, though. Mm-hmm. And they've looked at it, and they've really studied it, and they've looked at the effects of, let's say Boston plays Portland in round one, and you're flying 3,100 miles or 3,200 miles and three time zones and all that stuff, and it's a 2-2, 1-1-1 series. what is the effect on the team if it goes seven? I think they're really afraid of it. I wish they did it. I don't like the conferences. I don't really understand them. And over the course of NBA history, they've been really confused by the conferences. I wrote about this in the Book of Basketball, where we had years where San Antonio was playing in the East for a while, and Baltimore was in the West, which, go look at a map. Baltimore being in the West is ridiculous. Baltimore was in the West, and Philly was in the East, and they're like 50 miles away from each other.
Yeah, made no
sense. So they've never really 100% figured out the conferences, and I just think the 1 through 16 makes more sense.
It would sure be better basketball.
It would be better.
Yeah. Now, here's Dragic. They count on his contributions, currently providing 16.5 points a game.
He's looking confident right from the opening tip.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Good on the bucket.
Man, how about the vision of the hometown hero, George Hill, spotting a teammate and whipping it over quickly.
Rockets the pass to Hero. Crowder feeling it out a bit. Over Hill. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it, and it is good. Crowder's got five now. Bucks trail by nine, about 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. The pass to Lopez. Pass to DiVincenzo. And it's Miami with the rebound. The floater, Dragic gets the bucket.
Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Tell you what, forget about easing into the game. They came out with guns blazing.
And after just one quarter of play, a double-digit differential on the scoreboard. Heat lead by 11. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. Tough-nosed Jimmy Butler talks about the mantle of being a franchise player.
You call me a leader, all-star, whatever you want to call it, but with that comes a lot of, you know, some people call it pressure, but a lot of responsibility is what I call it. You know, every night, you got to show up. You have to be productive. You have to show guys, even when you're hurt, you can still play. Even when you're tired, you got to go out there and do what you're supposed to do. It's fun to me. I love it. I wouldn't have it any other way.
And that's what he worked for. And he works as hard as anyone, Greg, in the NBA.
And you see that competitiveness and desire in his play.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And quite a position here for the Heat to be in. What do you guys think?
What we saw in that first quarter, they won their matchups defensively.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, you look at the energy, the effort, defensively, they put it all out there in that opening quarter.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, as the second quarter gets going. On the court for the Heat, Dragic is out there with Iguodala. Then it's Olynyk. Then there's Myers Leonard. And it's Silva in at the three. And he gets it to go. Dragic has got the lead up to 11 now for Miami. Bill, it was in Boston where you received your master's degree in journalism. What attracted you to this profession? Why journalism?
I couldn't do anything else, and I didn't like manual labor.
No, really?
No, that really was it. I was good at writing.
Like anybody in your family or anybody you
know? No, I was always a good writer, and I liked writing and sports. Yeah. So I'm just kind of like, oh, I'll do those two things
together.
Did
it in high school, I'm assuming, right?
Yeah, started in high school. I had the big thing for me was in college. I had a column for the school newspaper, really from freshman year on. And around sophomore year, it felt like it started to get momentum. And that was the first time I thought, I wonder if I could get paid for this.
Right.
Which, as it turned out, no, until I was about 29.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, Chris Middleton was a first-time All-Star in 2019. Now, we all know that Middleton is one of the league's best shooters, but he had to adjust his game to a new system under coach Mike Budenholzer. Middleton said, I guess that's what being an All-Star is, a team player and a complete player. Not playing for stats, playing for nothing else but to win. Kevin?
First-time All-Star and well-deserved. David, thank you. Second quarter, and we're just over a minute in. Bledsoe looking it over. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Bledsoe's got his third basket of the night right there.
Yeah, so hard to defend Bledsoe in the screen and roll, specifically because of how unpredictable he is in these situations.
Nunn passes to Robinson.
Hey, right there!
No shot.
Outside Butler. Five on the clock. Releases from the wing and drills it. And the Heat lead by 14.
You know, I think Butler had a pretty good mid-range game coming in. You know, he was drafted 30th back in 2011.
Bledsoe with it. Leonard picks him up. No good from Bledsoe.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Just playing with poise and confidence, and they continue to put points on the board.
Boy, I like the way they're playing. A very smart first half, quality shots, not wasting possessions.
Cans it from downtown. Bledsoe's got 9 points.
You know, Bledsoe is a decent shooter from outside, but I think it's really important that he continues to connect from there.
Robinson dishes to Butler. Here's Nunn. He isn't playing a big part of their offensive scheme, averaging around 15 and a half points a game. Bucks trail by 13. Bledsoe left side. And Bledsoe with the stuff.
This is what Bledsoe loves doing. I mean, penetrating, probing, finding his way, looking to get close to the bucket. That's when he's at his best.
Out of bounds, Milwaukee takes possession. And a moment now to look at the year-to-year scoring output and how it has been trending for Lopez.
And maybe it's shocking, maybe, well, maybe not too shocking, but the scoring trend over the last few years has been going down a bit. I'm sure it's something he's well aware of, and we'll see if that continues to be the case.
That three off the mark. The Heat leading by 11. Here's Butler. Makes it off the glass. Butler's got 4 points in the quarter.
Really hard to stay with Jimmy Butler because he's so good at getting shots up and in past the defense. Just has a real knack for scoring even when challenged.
Here's Matthews. Sweet little floater. He's got 6.
Boy, that was a sweet-looking teardrop. There's very little defense for that.
For Miami, they've gone 5 of 7 from the field here in the second.
Who got ball?
Here's Nunn. Robinson for 3. And the Heat, another 3.
Gets the shot he wants. The defense wasn't quite connected enough. They lost contact.
And so it's Bledsoe with it, bringing it up for the Milwaukee Bucks. It's a 14-point game. Pass to Lopez. And he makes that one. Lopez has got his first 2 points.
Yeah, they've raised their shooting percentage in this quarter, and they're starting to get on track.
And they're starting to heat up is what they're doing. They're on fire. I mean, that's what they need to climb back into this game.
A moment now to see how the schedule is looking for the Bucks. On Saturday, they'll take on Steph Curry and the Golden State Warriors. And then on Monday, they'll face off against Jimmy Butler and the Miami Heat.
And looking at the Wizards matchup, that's going to be one where it would take a lot of errors and maybe a cold shooting night for things to go wrong. They just have that much of an advantage over that team.
You got to try to keep Bledsoe out of the lane. You can't let him get in there. As soon as that happens, you're in trouble, big trouble.
For Milwaukee, they have been perfect at the line so far, albeit just 2 for 2.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
The free throw drops for Eric Bledsoe.
And the key for Bledsoe, like it is for most players, is staying motivated and engaged. I mean, he's a big player for this team, an important player for this team.
Here's what Milwaukee's going with right now. Antetokounmpo comes in for Williams, and Middleton subbed in for Kyle Korver. Bledsoe hits them both. Now, here is Robinson. He has seven. Passes it to Nunn. Robinson goes in, and so Miami again turning it over. Defeated by the Hornets in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them. Looking at the last game for Milwaukee, it was a loss to Boston. Antetokounmpo kicks to Lopez. The pass to Matthews. They get it back. That's in, and the Miami lead is cut down to 8 on the bucket from Antetokounmpo.
You know, Antetokounmpo, for all of his skills and talent, he's a worker. This guy likes to grind and takes a lot of pride in outworking people on the boards.
Here's Butler, and two free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact. It goes on Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Yeah, the defender all over him.
Greg, he got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
For Miami, they have shot 67% from the line, going 6
Shooting
of 9.
Two.
No good on that one. Pat Connaughton, he's checked in for Milwaukee. And Miami also making a switch. Heroes checked in. Good on the second free throw. Bucks trail by 9. Bledsoe passes to Giannis. Back to Bledsoe. And the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
You know, Bledsoe is not a big guy, but he's got big boy strength. He's a powerful combo guard and can convert through contact.
He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far. The Bucks making a switch here. Ilyasova's checked in. And Miami also making a switch. Crowder's checked in. The free throw drops for Eric Bledsoe.
And didn't have a single free throw in that first quarter, but he started to play with a little bit more of an edge to his game here in the second.
Here's Nunn. Down low, here's Adebayo. And the rejection by Giannis. Middleton the pass to Bledsoe. From the baseline, here's Antetokounmpo, and the shot goes down.
You know, you appreciate the all-around game of the Greek Freak, hitting the boards with relentlessness.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight. Goran Dragic is checked in for the Heat.
Shooting one.
That's good from Antetokounmpo.
And they're getting to the line a lot in this quarter, guys, and it hasn't been by accident.
Yeah, I don't think it's an accident that aggressiveness correlates with playing better. So the aggressiveness is starting to pay off.
Kicks it to Crowder. Pass to Adebayo. Just 5 on the clock. No good from Dragic.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender.
And you know what? He's not going to give up an easy finish at the rim. I mean, that's just against his constitution.
Adebayo passes to Dragic. Here's Hero. Heat moving the ball around. Pass to Adebayo. Throws it up high. Jones trying to get open.
Oh, and just a soft touch on both ends of that pretty alley-oop.
I got to say, when he threw the pass, I didn't know where it was going.
Neither did the defense.
Jones against Bledsoe. And Jones pulls it down.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
The battle to a standstill on the boards has really been something to watch, and the game's not over yet. We'll see if one of these teams maintains more energy than the other going down the stretch.
A different look for Milwaukee. Dante DiVincenzo comes in for Pat Connaughton, and George Hills subbed in for Eric Bledsoe. Olynyk is checked in for the Heat. And it's Dragic off the drive. Some high-scoring teams in the NBA. Let's see the leaders. The Bucks, number one.
I mean, it's an exciting brand of basketball that they're playing. They've got such deadly weapons. Teams have had a heck of a time trying to slow them down.
Shooting two.
And that one falls for Dragic.
And Dragic came into the NBA with something on his resume that not many other rookies have. He has a ring from winning the Slovenian Pro League the year before he came to America.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots. Here is Hill. Outside, Antetokounmpo. And the dunk by Giannis.
Boy, the added work in the weight room for Giannis coming into play there. I mean, you got to send an army to try to stop this guy.
Miami leading by three. And Miami calls their first timeout of the game.
Well, it's been an express lane to the rim. Coach can't be happy about that.
And, you know, I think he's going to tell them simply, we have to show more fight on the interior. That's the top priority right now.
Robin Lopez is checked in for Ilyasova.
All right, a chance to check out stats here for George Hill. How the second half of the season has shaped up for him. He's putting up about 8 points a game, 2 assists, and 2 rebounds. And there isn't much to write home about with his numbers. I think he'd like to up his contributions.
Yeah, but you got to earn that chance. I mean, you get what you earn. His numbers are fine, but he's not going to get a lot more floor time unless he turns it up a notch.
Rejected by Dragic. Here's Hero. He's been a reliable scorer for him as he's averaging up over 13 points a game. And we'll get a look at how the hustle stat game has been going for Miami.
Great hustle defensively through the first half, contesting everything and racking up the block shots.
Another big aspect of their game tonight has been the fast break, transition opportunities. They're really keeping it up tempo so far.
Bill, we so appreciate you stopping by, spending some time with us. Always feels like there's so much more to talk about, which means we got to get you back here, if you don't mind.
Yeah.
We'll look forward to that.
Yeah, that'd be great.
And, Clark, you know what? Bill will always give you a great point of view.
And you know what? I think he needs his own barbershop talk show, Kevin. I mean, he's done everything else in media. Go barbershop on him, Bill.
The Heat leading by three. And here's Dragic, 11 points in the game. Over Hill, and it's wide right, hits off the rim.
Boy, just cannot buy a bucket, guys. I'll tell you what, that's a painful quarter for him, and it's painful for me to watch, too.
Dragic, the pass to Adebayo. That's in, coming off an assist from Dragic. Dragic has got 3 assists in the game. Milwaukee's gone 1-4 from three-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. Now, Antetokounmpo, he's got 9. From deep, And no luck with that time on the buzzer beater. And that's it for the first half of action in what's been a very close game here. Heat out front, up 5. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. Here with Jimmy Butler. Jimmy, you have come a long way in this league. When you look at your career now versus when you came in, how different is it?
Much different. I think on the floor, I'm supposed to do a lot more on both ends of the floor. And off the floor, I think it's still the same. People recognize my hair.
Well, it is a unique style. Jimmy, thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, folks, welcome back. Ernie Johnson alongside the Jet. That's Kenny Smith. The Diesel, that's Shaquille O'Neal. A lot of big-time action so far in this one. It was all about Miami as the game got going. During one stretch, they were leading by as many as 11, really playing as a unit. After a well-executed first quarter, they held the lead by 11. Going through the second quarter, they started to look a bit fatigued, but played well enough to enjoy a 5-point cushion here at the half. Kenny, let's start with you. What'd you think about the Heat?
Well, there was one pleasant surprise, and that was the bench. They gave them a big lift. Those guys came into the game, they did all the dirty work, and they scored baskets.
And you, big fella, let's get your thoughts on the Bucks.
The thing I like was how they were making a conscious effort to work the ball inside. They should do the same in the second half. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Whether running the offense through the post, driving it, doesn't matter. Get to the rim, and the rest will take care of itself.
And that should do it. With the second half about to begin, let's send you back to Kevin Harlan. Go back to Kevin Harlan. Go. Just go over there.
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. You know, Eric Bledsoe has been exceptional here, guys.
And how about the amount he's contributing in the scoring column? Through two quarters, he has been terrific.
And you know what? They've come at him a few different ways defensively, and nothing has slowed him down.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession.
Well, Milwaukee is exactly what a small market success story looks like.
Yeah, you know, a great eye for talent and also some good fortune in landing a player like Giannis in the draft. And small market teams have to home grow their superstars. Then they made smart moves surrounding Giannis with talent and an outstanding coach. The front office deserves buku credit for how they've turned this team into a finals contender.
Giannis is the 4 with Lopez the 5. Matthews and Middleton the 2 wings. And it's Bledsoe in at the 1 spot. That's the group for Milwaukee right now. Here's Nunn. Lopez with the block.
Great timing on Lopez's part there to swat down that attempt.
Here's Adebayo, and that comes off the assist by Jones. Adebayo's got 7 points in the game. Middleton outside. Passes it to Antetokounmpo. And Antetokounmpo slams it in.
You know, Bledsoe has developed his passing skills to the point where you've got to respect that part of his game. He's doing a nice job finding his open guys.
Robinson passes to Nunn. Back to Robinson. Matthews with a steal. Bucks trail by 3. Feeds to Bledsoe. They double-team Bledsoe. And here's Giannis from outside. Antetokounmpo can't get that one to fall. For Miami, they've gone 1-3 since starting the second half.
Just rubbing it in their faces with that dunk.
He is never going to take his foot off the pedal.
And that's terribly demoralizing for a defense, guys. I mean, they know he's going to keep coming and coming and coming, and that they may not have an answer for it.
And that one drops. 15 points in the game.
And he is really in a zone right now, playing and scoring with confidence.
None passes to Butler.
Come get it, come get it.
This one for three. No good on that one. Now the Bucks take it the other way. Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Here's Nunn, and it's sent back by Bledsoe.
Boy, that was well done by Bledsoe there. Nice timing on that block.
Back to Robinson. Down to five on the shot clock. The Heat need to get a shot off. Here's Nunn. No good with the triple.
No other way to put it. Just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack.
Here's Giannis. It's Adebayo with the rebound. Adebayo's got 9 rebounds now tonight. Back to Jones. It's Solomba to Tecumbo. Now the pass to Lopez. For the tie. Milwaukee the rebound. And Butler sends it back.
No denying it. Butler, a superb defender. Really does a nice job using his length to turn shots away.
Here's Adebayo. And he lays it straight in. Adebayo's got 9.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
Shoots it up. Milwaukee, no good that time either.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Nunn passes to Robinson. Dishes it to Butler. Shoots. And the rejection by Giannis. Middleton outside. Pass to Bledsoe.
Hey, who's watching?
Good, and the assist goes to Middleton. Middleton's got 3 assists tonight. And Clark, your love for the Buckeye State has never been questioned.
Time out.
The best part of growing up as a kid in Ohio?
Well, I think a number of things. One, having family around, extended family as well as immediate family, but also the sports love that exists throughout the state and being able to experience that and enjoy that with my dad and siblings. That's special. And having a career in basketball that I've had makes it even more special.
A big group substitution here for Milwaukee. Ilyasova, he's checked in for Lopez. Williams comes in for Giannis Antetokounmpo. Kyle Korver, he's checked in for Chris Middleton. And it's Pat Connaughton in for Wesley Matthews. The kick outside to Butler. Hits the 3-point bomb. Butler's got 10 points in the game.
And, you know, the timing Butler shows. Effective at going right up with his shot after the catch.
Pass to Korver. From downtown. The rebound by Iguodala. And so it's Iguodala. He'll bring it up for the Heat. At one point, they led by 16. Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a 3-point play. That's on Marvin Williams. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The scoring breakdown for the Heat.
Boy, their passing has been picturesque, a thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
And also, how about the points they've gotten in transition or on the fast break tonight? That's been a huge factor as well.
Hey, where did you get that? Bucks trail by 9. Pass to Connaughton.
I got yours.
That's all you.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. They get Andre Iguodala.
Nice work to get it inside and draw the contact.
Exactly. The defense determined not to allow the easy layup right there. They'll settle for making him earn the free throws.
Milwaukee shooting their 7th and 8th free throw attempts for the game right here.
Take a break. Two shots.
And he can't get the first one. And with this summer's signing of Jimmy Butler, the Miami Heat demonstrating they still can lure star talent to South Beach.
The Heat back on the rise. The Butler signing sets the stage for the summer of 2021 when they should have the cap space to sign another max player.
Dante DiVincenzo, he's checked in for Eric Bledsoe. He hits the second from the line. The Heat leading by 8. Iguodala with it. Outside Leonard. And the whistle blows. It'll be on Pat Connaughton. That is his first foul of the game. Bucks on defense. The shot by Butler. Nobody around.
No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going this quarter.
To the inside. And Ilyasova throws it down.
Boy, impressive intensity displayed by Ilyasova. He's a real energizer bunny type of guy who can sky up really fast and finish at the rim with a lot of force.
And again, it's the Heat missing. Bucks trail by 6. He dishes it to Korver. Bucks passing it around. Clock at 6. From deep three-point range, it's hauled in by the Heat.
And maybe he thinks he has that type of range, but I'm not sure who'd agree with him.
Yeah, you know what? Sometimes guys have the green light to take that shot, but I don't think he's one of them.
Here's Butler. 6 feet out. It's good. Butler's got 5 points in the quarter.
You know, you look at Butler's numbers. Every year he's been in the league, he's improved as a scorer. He knows how to get to his spots and then deliver.
No shot.
Here's DiVincenzo. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. A lot of guys like to shoot off the dribble, but Clark, there are some that really are better at it, shooting off that catch in the NBA.
Yeah, and who do you have in mind, Kevin? I got a couple of names that I'm thinking about. What about you?
Well, I'm thinking of Klay Thompson.
Shooting two,
because
yeah.
That backcourt is so prolific, and he's been so great at that, and that's kind of been his trademark.
Yeah, it has been. Reddick would be another guy.
Yes, another good
that
one.
I think that would come to mind, and even though he's later in his career now, but Kyle Korver, one of the very best we've had in the league at shooting off the catch.
And some changes here for the Bucks. Robin Lopez has checked in for Ilyasova. And it's Hill in for Kyle Korver. Olenek, he's checked in for the Heat. Hero comes in for Jimmy Butler. That one misses.
And that's a rare missed opportunity from him. He'd been good as gold up until that point.
The kick out to Dragic. Good D by Williams.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
And you know, guys, I love his fight and grit on the interior. I mean, he never lets a shot go uncontested.
Here's Hero. Up top, Dragic. He's guarded by Hill. Dragic gets the bucket.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Well, I agree with you. 4 of their last 5 baskets have been exactly of that variety.
And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touched by Hill. While there's a chance, let's show you the teams that have thrived on the fast break this season. In the third spot, the Bucks.
Yeah, I mean, they've got the athletes to run the break all game long. So that's their edge. They're always looking to take advantage.
The pass to Olenek.
Watch the screen.
To the middle. Here's Hero. Rebound by Williams. And it's Williams with the ball for the Bucks, trailing here by 8. Powered down as the whistle blows, a three-point play chance.
Boy, good pass from Williams. Not known for his passing, but I think he's got to keep hitting his guys with these kinds of passes.
For Milwaukee, they have made 7 free throws and missed 3 in this game.
And taking a look at their free throw statistics on the season, right around 74%.
And guys, you know what? That's made things hard for them in a lot of their games. I mean, that inability to convert their chances at the free throw line.
Lopez, he's checked in for the Bucks. Giannis Antetokounmpo comes in for Williams. Miami leading by 5. There's 1:47 left here in the third quarter. Plenty of space. Shots good by Hero. Hero's got his third basket of the night. Milwaukee has gotten off to a very slow start from three-point range in the second half. They're 0-4. Rockets against Hill. On the wing, Giannis. No good. And it's Miami the other way. At one point, they led by 16. Next up for them, the Knicks coming out here to play. That game marks the first half of a quick 2-game homestand. Dragic taking his time here. He kicks to Olynyk. 5 to shoot. And the 3 off target. Bucks trail by 7. Floats it up for Giannis. Up high to stuff the alley-oop.
Love the read there from Antetokounmpo. I mean, his basketball IQ is really impressive when it comes to alley-oop attempts.
Pass to Hero. Good ball movement here by Miami. Now Olynyk. Oh, he's going up for the alley-oop here. An emphatic alley-oop jam.
Oh, phenomenal alley-oop slam there.
They are taking advantage of a team that looks lost out there.
Boy, I tell you what, guys, this is really getting close to being real ugly.
The Bucks have attempted 11 free throws today and converted 8 of them.
Shooting 2.
Free throw good, Giannis.
And though he's still young, Giannis Antetokounmpo is already elite. I mean, his athleticism and length, really hard to contain.
The Bucks making a switch here. Matthews has checked in. So 1-for-2 that time at the stripe. The Heat leading by 6. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. It's stolen by Hill. Oh, and here we go. Antetokounmpo, nobody back.
And Hill jumps the passing lanes like a jaguar. Ridiculous instincts, which help lead to high percentage attempts on the other end.
Agic against Hill. To the left side wing. Here's Hero. And a miss there on the triple. And we've reached the end of the third. Heat lead by 4. And after a quick break, we're going to come right back with the start of the fourth quarter. And a quick look now at the State Farm assist of the game.
And he sliced the D wide open with this feed. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
Yeah, that's just a brilliant read of the defense. I mean, it was also excellent anticipation of the movement of his teammates before the pass. Just great harmony on all sides.
And with three quarters behind us, we start the fourth quarter in what is still anybody's ballgame. On the floor for Miami, starting the fourth. In the middle, it's Olynyk and Adebayo. Dragic is out there with Hero. And it's Crowder in at the small forward position. Here's Dragic. Basket counts. And the Heat lead by six.
That finish brings me back to the old days, the silky smooth finger roll.
The shot by Antetokounmpo, nobody around, Lopez. Offensive rebound.
Who got ball?
Hill up top. He's guarded by Dragic.
Watch the screen.
Don't get hit.
Dragic against Hill, and it's Dragic with the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game. Eric Bledsoe's checked in for the Bucks. Giannis inside, defended by Jones. Four on the clock, near the three-point line, it's Bledsoe. Here's Giannis. Got it. Good job in the low post. Giannis has got 13 points in the second half.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebounding advantage is starting to add up.
Yeah, still close, but with their tough play on the boards, we're certainly seeing the effort.
To the paint, here's Robinson. A good finish at the rack off the slick feed.
And the D not really doing its job there. A little slow to react to the ball getting into the paint.
Bledsoe outside. Pass to Giannis. Shoots a fader. Good, and Bledsoe gets the assist. Bledsoe's got three assists now in this one.
Boy, I think the confidence Antetokounmpo has from the mid-range area is really evidence of the strides he's making with his jump shot.
Crowder against Giannis. Shot left block. And another shot. Shot by Crowder, no good.
And he did everything he could to make that shot as difficult as possible.
And you know what, guys? That will pump him up because he takes a ton of pride in what he does on defense.
That one falls. Now just a two-point Miami lead. Heat have gone 2 of 4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. For those just joining us, fourth quarter here, we're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Here's Nunn, guarded by Bledsoe. Nunn passes to Jones. Three-pointer, Crowder. They get a hand on it.
And he's been a force on the glass all game long.
Yeah, I love the way he's fighting through box outs, using his elbows. I mean, he's doing whatever it takes.
Switch.
Here's Giannis. The shot goes down, and it gets this game back to even. Giannis has got 8 points here in this quarter.
You know, when you're talking about guys who can score over anybody, Antetokounmpo's name always comes up. So hard to defend.
Passes it to Adebayo. Inside, stolen by Middleton.
Watch that shooter.
Here's Bledsoe. Good, and the assist goes to Middleton. And it's now 22 points for Eric Bledsoe. And taking a quick look here at the hustle stats for the Bucks.
Boy, their hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end, very impressive. And they forced quite a few turnovers as a result.
They have, but you also can't overlook how well they've defended the rim, as they've challenged every shot and also gotten quite a few blocks as well.
And the shot's good from Crowder.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
Yeah, that's not the defense you need. You got to be tougher defensively.
Bledsoe left side. Kicks to Middleton.
Right here, back door.
Lopez outside. Shot clock at six. Bledsoe for three. And he's good on the three ball. Bledsoe's got 25 points in the game.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
Crowder against Middleton. Lopez with the block. And that's out of bounds. Miami will retain possession. The Heat making a switch here. Butler's checked in. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Matthews.
Great instincts from him to get a hand on that pass and tip it out.
And, you know, even though they didn't come up with the steal, that's still a nice defensive play.
Middleton against Butler. Fade away.
The length of Middleton, really an asset on defense for him. He's so good at getting his hands up quickly to contest shots.
And Bam Adebayo. He just plays with so much energy when he's on the floor.
Boy, he is ferocious on both ends of the floor. Great energy player who can finish in the paint with the best of them. Very quick on his feet and can cover a lot of ground for a player his size.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
The first one falls. He's perfect from the line this time. And here's Giannis. He'll bring it up for Milwaukee. They've given up just 8 points in the fourth quarter. The dish to Matthews.
Lopez.
And the pass to Lopez. Shot clock at 5. Butler with the steal. Pass to Nunn. Back to Butler. Lopez with the block, and he recovers it. Robinson passes to Adebayo. That doesn't go in. Had a chance, though, to take the lead. The shot by Middleton, wide open. They get it again. Antetokounmpo can't get it to go.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
And you know, guys, I love his fight and grit on the interior. I mean, he never lets a shot go uncontested.
Robinson finds Adebayo over Bledsoe. Gets it to go. That one good from Adebayo.
Yeah, you know, we've seen a much different version of him in this half, guys. He's been sharper, more focused, and more assertive.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee.
Every timeout, a chance to review the lineups, matchups, or call a play.
Yeah, and I agree. I think there's going to be a new wrinkle in their game plan when they come out of this timeout.
And now the presentation of our Jordan player of the game, Goran Dragic.
And the way he's made his mark with his work inside, he's just been a slasher tonight. Always moving, getting to the basket at will, and just seemingly taking advantage of a D that was reluctant to get in his way.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Hey, guys, I was able to listen to what Mike Budenholzer told his team during that timeout. Not happy with the way this game is going. He said, you're getting used out there on the perimeter. Inside the arc, we're doing some good things, but outside, we're a disaster. Tighten it up. Kevin, we'll see if they can close out on their shooters a little more effectively.
Thanks, David.
And Butler just excellent at finding ways to get to the stripe, especially when he's near the basket.
And you look at Jimmy Butler. Goes about 6'8", about 230 pounds. Great size on the wing.
And he keeps himself in tip-top shape. His strength, one thing I'm not sure the casual fan even recognizes.
Two shots.
Free throw, good Butler. And the hard scramble upbringing for Jimmy Butler, well chronicled in Houston, Texas. He says it played a part in making him the person Clark he is today, but it doesn't explain him.
That's a great way to put it, Kevin, because we are certainly influenced by our experiences and our past, but it doesn't dictate where we'll go in the future. He bounced around for 4 years in different places from age 13 on. No recruiting buzz out of high school, and from there to here, that's a major climb. Credit to Jimmy Butler.
Pass to Bledsoe. Floats it up for Giannis, and Antetokounmpo slams it in.
Hey, you know, in the age of analytics, there's a ton of talk about player efficiency these days, and as we can see by Antetokounmpo's performance tonight, his efficiency, extraordinary.
Robinson passes to Nunn. Over Bledsoe. Miami no good on that time either.
You know, even though they're on top in this one, you'd like him to be better out there because he's capable of being better. It sure would make things a lot easier, too.
And they pick up two. That's now 32 points for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Strong work for him at the offensive end, helping them to maintain that lead.
Robinson passes to Nunn.
Come to me. Squeeze.
Over Bledsoe, he sinks the 11-footer. And the Heat lead by one. We've seen some great competition in this one.
Yeah, seven timeout, already timeout in the game. And I think it shows you how well these two teams match up with one another.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. Goran Dragic is checked in for the Heat. Middleton outside. And he lobs it up.
And Middleton is just the total package, not just a scorer, but a terrific passer as well.
Now, here's Dragic. And the Heat call time here.
Timeout. Start it.
Jones kicks to Dragic. To the inside. It's tipped. And it's out of bounds. The Heat able to retain possession here. Lopez with the steal. Now the Bucks moving it up. The big dunk at the end of the break.
Man, what a special player Antetokounmpo is, sharing the sugar there. The vision he showed, nice job finding the open man.
Butler against Middleton. Here's Jones. Goes back up. Draws contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
And challenging the bigger defender coming through in the biggest moment.
Well, this guy is always in attack mode, very aggressive. Some players might kick it out there, not him. He's going right to the bucket.
One shot.
And that one falls for Jones.
Hey, great job to get the bucket and to get to the line. When the game's on the line, you want your guys attacking like he did there.
And here is Antetokounmpo. And Giannis throws it down.
You know, feeling very comfortable taking a big shot when his team needs it, that's a sign of how Antetokounmpo has matured recently.
Jones trying to get open, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
Two.
2.
He hits the first one, and that narrows the gap to 1. And so Butler nails both of them.
And really, the tension could not be higher right now. And he looked like he was shooting free throws at practice. What a cool customer.
Watch the pick.
Dragic against Bledsoe. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
You know, Bledsoe is so athletic and plays with such great energy, it's hard to defend him sometimes without fouling.
Take a break. 2 shots.
So the first one drops, and that gives them the lead. And so he drops them both. It's a 2-point ball game.
And how about the composure there at the line? A ton of pressure on those free throws, and he knocks them both down.
There's 53 seconds left to play in the final quarter. And it's sent back by Lopez. And so the ball goes out of bounds. Lopez touched it last.
Butler!
50 seconds left to play here in the fourth. 6 on the shot clock. Time to get open is Robinson, and it's Butler missing.
I wonder if switching baskets really threw him off. I mean, because he can't get anything to fall this half.
And so here is Miami. Dragic with it, now guarded by Antetokounmpo. Dragic, the pass to Jones. Here's Butler. Good! He has tied up this game. Oh, what a shot.
Oh, you just love seeing a player with absolutely no fear.
Cool, calm, collected, and confident in the biggest moment of the game? Yes.
So Mike Budenholzer decides to take a timeout here. Sixteen seconds left in the fourth. Now Bledsoe. Launches it. No good from 3-point territory. Now a timeout called by Miami. For the win. Oh, and a chance to win the game, but the last second shot is offline. And regulation now complete. We will go to overtime. And we'll get going after this from Milwaukee. Well, four quarters weren't enough to decide this ball game. Sit back and enjoy as we move on to overtime.
All right.
Tip-off goes to Milwaukee. And always a good ride in these post-regulation battles. This overtime now looking to be an exciting one. All fueled up and ready to go to overtime basketball here, brought to us by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. On the floor for Miami, Jones is out there with Adebayo. Then there's Jimmy Butler. Then there's Dragic. And it's Robinson in at shooting guard. Dragic against Bledsoe. Dragic gets the bucket.
You know, the defense has to be better. I mean, you can't give up that look.
Giannis kicks to Matthews. Middleton on the wing, defended by Butler. From down in the low post, it goes. And the Bucks lead by two.
Persistent.
Dragic the pass to Jones. Matthews against Robinson. Outside Butler. Six to shoot. And they double up Butler. It's hauled in by Giannis. Antetokounmpo's. There's the lob. Antetokounmpo throws down the alley-oop slam. Time out.
Matthews has a nice feel, guys, for when a teammate has a clean look, gets him the ball.
Now a timeout called by Miami. The Heat making a switch here. Nunn's checked in. The Heat trail by four. We're in overtime and 90 seconds gone here in what has been a great one so far. Good ball movement here by Miami. Stolen by Bledsoe. And it's Middleton penetrating. Good on the shot.
Well, you always like to see a guy show the kind of effort Middleton does. I mean, just willing himself to the bucket through and past contact.
Butler against Middleton. The 11-footer. The putback, and no good. The Bucks go the other way with it. And they double up on Antetokounmpo. And Bledsoe has it in the corner. A baseline J. Good as the jump shot falls. And now it's an 8-point Bucks lead.
Nice play, and you can see they're gathering momentum.
You know, they need to stay aggressive here. Build the lead up while they've got the chance. Don't waste this opportunity.
Here's Nunn, guarded by Bledsoe. Just five to shoot. To halt the run. Miami no good on that time either.
Fantastic positioning there to contest that one.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, he challenged the shot, and you can see the effects on the release of that shot. I mean, it turned a simple jumper into a tough one.
Here's Lopez, and there are the Bucks with another bucket.
Boy, you have to be impressed with the offensive production. They have got it firing on all cylinders.
And, you know, the lead just keeps growing. I mean, this game is not going to get out of their grip. They're going to keep pulling away.
None, that's good.
Boy, you don't want to leave guys unattended, not around a guy like Butler, who's pretty good at finding the open guy.
And Bledsoe, here we go. And it's Miami with the rebound.
And not sure they've got enough time to save themselves.
It doesn't look good, even with a quick bucket here.
And here's Giannis. He'll bring it up for Milwaukee, leading by five. Pass to Lopez. Over Adebayo. Lopez, no luck. Now the Heat with it. Down low, Jones. And it's sent back by Lopez. And so they foul intentionally. And that's an intentional foul.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good, and that increases their lead to 6. And the second free throw, no good. A tough break there.
No time to waste on this possession.
Got to go right up with it and then foul immediately.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Butler kicks to Robinson, and there's the pass to Nunn. No good on the triple. And now they decide to foul intentionally. He doesn't hit the first, and that was the one they really wanted. He's got one more, though. And the second of two is good. That makes it a 7-point lead. And the Heat call time here. They're behind by 7. 5 seconds left in overtime. Pass to Silva. For 3. Gets the 3 to fall.
Timeout. Timeout. Start it.
So a close game sees Milwaukee taking this one. And they had some nervous moments down the stretch, but things finally came together for them in overtime.
Yeah, probably didn't anticipate that this one would be that close down the wire. But give them credit, they were able to regroup in that overtime and this win.
All right, David, thank you. Thank you for joining.